My name is Tim Card. I've been married to my wife, Tricia, for almost 20 years. We have 7 kids. The oldest is 18, the youngest is 5. We live here in Mountjoy. We've lived here for 11 years now.
No, come on, bring it in.
I'm not throwing it in that far.
Throw it.
Oh,
yes. Give me another. Hit me again. Yeah.
It all kind of felt surreal. Like it felt like an out-of-body experience. Like this isn't happening to me. This can't be right. Like I'm 40 years old. I'm in the best shape of my life. Like there's no way I have cancer. This is silly. It's something else. This is something else. Every rung you go down the ladder, your chances of beating this get less and less. We've done R-CHOP. We've done 2 rounds of that salvage chemo. I've done a round of radiation. You know, it keeps coming back. Like it keeps not responding to the treatment very well. CAR T came into play because the type I have is called diffuse large B cell non-Hodgkin lymphoma, and that's one of the specific types of cancer that CAR T fights.
40% of all non-Hodgkin's lymphoma are diffuse large B cell lymphoma, and that is one of the most common type and one of the type that is very aggressive and sometimes have a difficulty treating.
The CAR T is taking Tim's lymphocytes out of him, and that's done through a process called pheresis. So he had to have a special catheter put into his chest to allow us to get adequate blood flows for the machine to get the lymphocytes out of him. Those cells are then shipped out to California to the Kite Pharmaceutical Company manufacturing plant. They're infected with the viruses that have certain sequences that we're trying to convert Tim's lymphocytes too, and that they then have to be grown up to sufficient quantity. That process takes about 17 days.
Thank you. I'll see you next week.
Yeah, I think I'm going to be doing it on Monday.
Okay.
He then came in on a Sunday, and on Monday at 1 o'clock, we took those little frozen bag of cells, thawed those, and then infuse that over about 30 minutes' time.
We're gonna check your band here.
Have
a meal
voucher?
Yeah. This is Timothy Hart, date of birth 4/9.
This was definitely the hardest thing I've ever done. Hands down. Hands down the hardest thing I've ever done. I'm feeling strong enough to bring the world into. Feels like ever since we left this place. And I think a lot of it was that just because it was condensed. It was in such a short time frame. Like it was 17 days from start to finish. By the time I got in, by the time I got out, it was 17 days. But it was a really bad 17 days. And it felt like there was no rest from it. There was no relief. It just kept coming for that whole time. Yeah, so it was hard. It was very physically, emotionally very demanding.
This is right where the problem was, right there.
Okay.
And I don't see, you know, there may always be residual abnormality, and that technically is then partial remission.
Okay.
The spot that was there before that was bright is gone. But to my eye, this looks all very good.
I really had a hard time believing it. We've been so primed for bad news for so long. Good news was kind of unexpected. We didn't really know what to do with it. I think it was November 16th. It was the first day I got on my bike. I decided I'm going to get better now. Like I'm not just going to recover. I'm going to get better. I'm going to start working back to where I was before I got sick. Like that's really where I want to be. I want to be close to where I was at before I got sick. And I had to start someplace.
We are very proud and we are very happy about that. We are able to bring in this new treatment strategy to this area, and we are very happy that we are actually treating these patients. They are getting better.
The nurses, the staff, everybody at Hershey Medical was phenomenal. And just from the moment I walked through the door, you know, from the greeters and the valet all the way to the docs, like everybody was just incredible. And I can't thank them enough for saving my life.